Hi.
Hi, good morning.
Hello. Welcome on Montenegro Film Festival.
Thank you for having us here.
Santen is a very interesting movie, and from production point of view, there are a small Greek island, and most of the things are happening on a nudist beach. How was the challenging for production?
Yeah, it was sort of a production nightmare. Because, as you said, the island was very small, and we shot it in August, which is like the high season for the island. So it was also full of tourists that were doing their vacations there. What we did was we all stayed at a camping site. What you see in the film, where the actors are staying, all the crew and cast stayed there, apart from the protagonist. And we would do everything under the sun, or, you know, shooting very long days, and then, or we were shooting all night when we had the club scenes and all that, and then we would have to sleep in the morning under the sun. And so, yeah, it was a challenge, though. It was.
Film, ako niste gledali Toplotni udar, se dešava na jednom malom grčkom ostrvu i na nudističkoj plaži većim dijelom, pa sam pitao koliko je to bila izazovno za produkciju. Fedor kaže da je to bila producentska noćna mora, jer su snimali u avgustu tokom pune sezone, da je tamo bilo dosta turista. S druge strane, oni su bili smješteni u kampu koji se vidi u filmu i dobar dio radnje se dešava tamo i svi su bili smješteni tu, ali također bio je problem što je snimali su tokom dana po jakom suncu i po svemu, ali s druge strane su imali duge noćne scene, jer se također dobar dio dešava po noćnim klubovima. You have two really interesting actors in the movie. One is very well known, and the girl is a debutant.
Exactly. Yeah. We were looking for the main actor. Argyris was looking for the main actor for a couple of months. He was not sure, but when we thought of Makis and he went out with him, he just had a coffee with him, and he came back and he was like, I'm sure, I know it, it's him, he's gonna do it, he's perfect. And then we started looking for Anna, and it was very difficult because we needed a fresh face, so we needed someone that had not been in film before, and we had to look all over the schools, or, you know, people that had just graduated. And yeah, we were very lucky to find Ellie, who was then on her second year of studies. I don't know, she's phenomenal. If you've seen the film, you know it. And I think she will have a long career. She's acting now more, and she has also offers from abroad. So, yeah, we're proud of her.
U filmu imaju dvije glavne uloge, su ovako vrlo impresivne. Jedan je njihov poznati glumac Makis, druga je debitantkinja Ellie, pa sam pitao kako su njih pronašli. Dakle, glavnog glumca je reditelj tražio nekoliko mjeseci i onda sjetio Makice, popio kafu, razgovarali su i poslije toga je bio siguran da je upravo to što traži, a za ulogu, glavnu žensku ulogu, trebalo im je novo i svježe lice, dakle neko ko nikada nije bio na filmu, i onda su obilazili glumačke škole i na kraju su pronašli Ellie, koja se pokazala kao jako dobar izbor, i ona je sigurno da će ona imati vrlo dugačku i uspješnu karijeru. Now everybody talks about Greek New Wave in cinema. What do you think about that?
I think that after Lanthimos win in Un Certain Regard back in the day with Dogtooth, what happened was that many people that were into the film business and many people that wanted to go into the film business realized that it was possible for Greek cinema to travel abroad, to reach wider audiences, and all in all to have a wider audience, because, you know, we're a small country, we have a small production, And you know, sometimes you make a movie and it sucks when it's out in the theaters, like, you know, 2,000 people go see it and you're like, why am I doing this? So what happened with Lanthimos was that, you know, he showed us another way. And I think that, you know, many people with different backgrounds and, you know, different ideas and different aesthetics set out and made films. Some of them, you know, did very well in the global scene, others not so well. I don't think there's like a common thread in aesthetics, more than, you know, a love of the medium and, you know, a need to reach out to a wider audience.
Pitao sam je cijela ova priča oko grčkog novog talasa, o tome se govori već duže vremena u evropskoj kinematografiji, šta ona misli o tome. I kaže da je upravo Yorgos Lanthimos, kada je bio i njegova pobjeda u selekciji Uncertain Regard u Kanu, na neki način otvorila vrata grčkom filmu, ali također i pokazala svim ljudima koji se bave filmom u Grčkoj da je to moguće i da je moguće doći do mnogo šire publike. Kaže da je Grčka mala zemlja, da ima malu produkciju, da se nekada desi da film vidi samo 2000 ljudi i da je to naravno ovako nezadovoljavajuće, ali da je Lanthimos upravo pokazao da postoji drugačiji put i da sad u Grčkoj ima jedna generacija različitih ljudi, različitih estetika, dakle koji na drugačiji način gledaju na film, dakle nemaju neki zajednički put i pravac, ali svi jako vole filmsku umjetnost i s druge strane su, zahvaljujući ovom primjeru, vidjeli da za grčki film postoji neka šira publika. Ili ima neko pitanje, možda za Fedru? Izvolim.
Exactly. It was, production-wise, it was not a good decision. In fact, I advise against it. But the film was conceived in Christmas of the, you know, before the summer we shot it. The idea came in Christmas. The script was written in like a month, and the director was like, "We have to do this now. We have to do it this summer. And I need the island to be vibrant, and I need the island to be lively." And you know, we tried, you know, to dissuade him from doing that, but he was very confident in his vision, and you know, he's a very capable director. I mean, he's done many, many things, not only in film. He's also a commercial director. He shoots in advertising, so he has very big experience with shooting. So we all sort of, you know, trusted him, and it was for the best, because in the end, you know, the atmosphere you get in the film, it's very real. You get that, you know, everyone's on holidays, they're partying, it's wild. And we, for sure, we didn't have the money, you know, to recreate such atmosphere with like extras or, you know, places to make them look so crowded and stuff. Thank you.
Dakle, pitanje je bilo koliko je ta odluka uopšte bila dobra da se snima na ostrvu u Grčkoj u sred turističke sezone. Odgovor je, dakle, nije bila dobra odluka, ona je savjetovala da se to ne radi, ali cijela ideja za film je stigla za Božić. Reditelj je vrlo brzo razradio tu ideju i za nekih mjesec dana napisao je scenariju i želio je da snima odmah tog ljeta i trebalo mu je da to bude, želi ostrvo kada je živa atmosfera, kada ima veliki broj ljudi. Olakšavajuća stvar je bila što je on čovjek koji ima, vjeruje u svoju viziju, ima veliko iskustvo, vrlo je vješt, radio je veliki broj reklama, ali s druge strane također je to što je bila stvarna sezona i što je bilo mnogo ljudi, njima olakšalo posao, jer oni s druge strane ne bi imali novca da plaćaju različite statiste ako bi to snimali u periodu kada na ostrovu ne bi bilo dovoljno ljudi. Još neko pitanje? Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
film Kada dan nije imao ime, Teone Strugar Mitevske, Haris Bugašov, Leon Ristov i Stefan Kitanović, koji, eto, tu ste. Dobar dan.
Dobar dan.
Dakle, film Teone Strugar Mitevske koji je imao premijeru na Berlinskom filmskom festivalu, ovdje u zvaničnoj selekciji festivala. Ako ne znam koji dalje je gledao film, dakle, to je priča o jednoj mladoj ekipi, mladim momcima i upravo je ovaj casting zbog toga tu. I mi smo i pričali tada u Berlinu, razgovarali poslije filma, ali mene zanima kako ste došli, koliko ste se vi uopšte bavili glumom prije ovoga i kako vas ste ono pronašli.
Može na ili jamski?
Može i šta god hoćeš.
Okay. Da idemo? Kako pak pitanje?
How Teona finds you?
Aha, so there was a casting, and we, I think around 300 people applied, and we had several rounds of casting wherein we tried different roles as well, and then finally we were the ones to get picked, luckily.
Dakle, pitao sam kako ih Teona pronašla. Bio je veliki casting, više od 300 ljudi se prijavilo, bilo je nekoliko rundi, dakle, u više navrata su dolazili i na kraju bili su srećni da je Teona izabrala njih troje. Did anyone of you have previous acting experience?
Well, I had only one in a short movie, and that was all. And they didn't have.
Pitao sam ih za prethodno glumačko iskustvo, on imao samo jedno u kratkom filmu. This movie also depicts one pretty important situation and delicate situation for Macedonia. Did you have some problems after the movie in your community or something like that?
Well, actually it's not screened yet in Macedonia. Probably it's going to be next month, so we'll see.
Dakle, film se bavi jednom vrlo delikatnom situacijom, na neki način je i zasnovan i nije zasnovan na istinitom događaju, ali veliki broj ljudi u Makedoniji asocira na taj jedan veliki zločin koji se desio, pa sam ih pitao da li su možda imali neke probleme u vezi toga, ali film još uvijek nije prikazan u Makedoniji, tako da bit će narednog mjeseca. Did this experience change your life?
Well, in a way, because we got to travel around the world, I mean around Europe, it was kind of fun, but other than that, it kind of didn't, but I don't know for them, but I don't do acting, I'm not into acting or cinematography, so maybe they learned something, their experience was different, I guess.
I'd say that
Može, dakle, za njega, pitao se na koji način i da li je to iskustvo i snimanje filma promijenilo njihov život. On je rekao da su putovali po Evropi i da je bilo zabavno i zbog toga, ali da on nije u glumi i da njega gluma ne zanima previše.
I'd say the experience was interesting because since we were amateur actors, we were cast to be similar to our roles. And then I find, now it's 2 years after we shot the film, that I'm very similar and to my character, and things he has done, he does in the film, I now do in real life. So I think it was an interesting, I guess, self-reflection.
Dakle, da je bilo iskustvo, je bilo jako zanimljivo, pošto su oni bili na castingu, dakle, tako su tražili glumce da liče na likove koje igraju i on je, dakle, poslije tog iskustva, pošto je prošlo 2 godine od snimanja, shvatio da on upravo radi neke stvari koje taj lik radi u filmu, tako da je shvatio da on vrlo liči na taj karakter koji je napisao.